You're listening to a community story from Be My Eyes.
My name is Miloš Pržić. I am from Serbia. I'm totally blind and I am a PhD student as well as a researcher working for the Institute of Literature and Art in Belgrade, Serbia. I am a member of the local blind community. I'm a member of the local Rotary Club. I also done some judo and I also play traditional Serbian musical instruments as well as accordion. I learned about Be My Eyes when I was in Trieste, Italy, while studying for my master's degree. But back then, only iPhone users were the privileged one to have the possibility to use Be My Eyes, as I am a devoted Android user. When it came to Android, I actually couldn't wait and started experimenting, actually. For example, not only did I ask volunteers to help me with colors, stuff that is with colors and everyday stuff. I once asked a volunteer to help me watch a judo match on a live stream. She was from Brazil and she was like, "Oh, but I don't know any judo terms." And I asked her, no, it doesn't matter. You should just tell me what does the person in blue do and what does the person in white do, and I will understand everything. So the match was 5 minutes long and she did such a nice description that it's one of the most memorable experiences. The most memorable, the most unique experience with Be My Eyes, though, was with an old Renaissance text from the Italian literature that I had to read for my research. The text was so... I will show it here. So the text was so unusual, I'd say, that OCR softwares couldn't recognize it. So I had to call Be My Eyes to print the text out and to ask a volunteer, an Italian volunteer, to read it for me. So I sent her a PDF file of the scan and she read and dictated me what I asked her for. The interesting thing about the text is that it is a text from 1497 and it is a poem that reconstructs a trip of Neapolitan queen, and the important part for me was the part when she went to a small city where some Slavic people were there, and they sang a song in her honor. And the interesting stuff with the song is that the author, who was Italian and who didn't speak any Slavic language, wanted to reconstruct it. So what he did was pretty randomized way of reconstruction. Whether my task was to find out whether the reconstruction was good, how much, and to try to make one of the reconstructions real Serbian reconstruction of the text. So what the volunteer did, actually, she helped me contribute to the science. My sphere of research is the Balkans, the Balkan identity, cultural and geographical frame seen through the Italian literature. So the research I was doing had in mind the Slavic Balkan, Slavic culture within the Balkan, seen through the Renaissance Italian literature. So from, let's say, the 15th century up to the end of the 16th century. As I use Serbian language as the primary language on the Be My Eyes app, I had to change the settings so that I could be sure that an Italian volunteer would answer, because otherwise I'm not sure that we would have done what we had to do. This text was pretty much old, and even if someone speaks the modern Italian, it is pretty impossible that the person could read out aloud fluidly what I had to do. For example, imagine reading a Shakespearean text with someone who is not native speaker of English. Would be very difficult. So the first task was finding someone who is native, who is whose Italian is perfect, and then proceed. All the volunteers seem to take very responsibly what they do, even though most of them, if not all of them, whom I talked to, were first-time volunteers. So even the girl who volunteered with helping me with my research, it was her first Be My Eyes call. And after the call, which was an hour long, I told her to not be afraid that not everyone will be a scientist, and that not everyone will ask her to read strange texts, hoping, of course, that there are more blind scientists out there who would actually need and who can trust and rely on Be My Eyes. Before being able to ask a Be My Eyes volunteer to help out with something, it was pretty much impossible to make and do many things on one's own. And the privacy is also preserved, because the volunteer actually doesn't know you, even if they see you. If you want to do something and you must call and you must video call someone whom you know, maybe you don't want them to, I don't know how much money do you have, or to read your bills or whatever. If you call a volunteer, they don't know anything about you. They read out and look for what you need, and you have your privacy. The volunteer has their own privacy, and actually they are just what the name of the app says, your eyes, nothing more, nothing less. Absolutely recommend people to use Be My Eyes, because the possibilities and use cases are unlimited. People will be able to help out with everything, and even if you have something, even if you have a task that would take a long time, you can ask a volunteer if they have that time. If they don't, no one gets angry. If they do, of course, you can then proceed. If not, you can call another one. So the possibilities are endless. There are almost no limitations, and I think that everyone can find Be My Eyes useful for their own needs, be it for work, be it for watching football, be it for everyday things like reading out stuff and recognizing colors, etc.
Thank you for listening to this community story from Be My Eyes. You can share your story too. Send it to mystory@bemyeyes.com. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, download our app, or visit bemyeyes.com/community-stories for more.